Roots. Wherever the mayor of East Haven goes, ever since his infamous taco comment, controversy seems to follow. A simple news conference to announce an upcoming event turned into a shouting match between the mayor and some of his most vocal critics. News 8's Aaron Cox was there when everything went down. She joins us now live from News 8 Control with the story. Aaron.
Keith, what a scene it was. The press conference had just ended and Mayor Joe Maturo had simply opened it up for questions. And that's when some Latino residents confronted him, basically calling him out, accusing him of avoiding them, being unwilling to meet face to face.
Can I do that, please? No, this is not the opportunity to make it political. You delivered the message. It is on my desk. And if you'd like an appointment with me, you're welcome to make it.
For the Latino community.
Well, that was the leader of an immigrant group trying to give the mayor a letter claiming he refuses to meet with residents on the police profiling issue. It all happened in the auditorium at East Haven High School. Officials gathering to announce the Latino Expo would be there in the first week of May. Something that was organized soon after four police officers were indicted by the feds on charges of targeting and harassing Latinos. Now, several residents stood up. They were simply shouting questions at the mayor.
I would like to see his face because he's hiding behind you. Okay, I would like to see him.
Yeah.
When you made the comments, tacos, and he's not even listening, I guess he doesn't even care about the Latino community, as you can see. Okay? As a tax, excuse me, don't interrupt me, please. Don't interrupt me, please. Please, show some education. I do have a question as a citizen of East Haven, not as an organization, as a citizen.
If you give me your name and number, I will call you up when I get back to the office.
And just from hearing that, you can sense there is certainly still tension in the East Haven community. Now, the mayor walked away from the podium, and then the residents simply got up and they left the auditorium. Afterwards, they told me they felt this was their only way to try and speak with Mayor Joe Maturo. Reporting live this afternoon from News 8 Control, I'm Erin Cox. Keith, back to you.